हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू अवर चैनल। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट क्वांटिटी ऑफ स्टॉर्म वाटर। द क्वांटिटी ऑफ स्टॉर्म वाटर इज कैलकुलेटेड बाय यूजिंग टू मेथड्स विच आर द रैशनल मेथड एंड एम्पिरिकल फॉर्मूली मेथड। इन दिस टू मेथड द क्वांटिटी ऑफ स्टॉर्म वाटर इज अ फंक्शन ऑफ एरिया विच इज टेकन इन हेक्टर्स, द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ रेनफॉल एंड कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ रन ऑफ। The coefficient of runoff or the maximum rate of runoff, it depends upon the surface slope and the estimated condition of drainage area with reference to the proportion of the rainfall that will run. So let's see the rational method. The rational method is used to determine the quantity of storm water. The storm water quantity is determined by this formula, which says Q is equals to C into I into A upon 360. Let's see the terms contains in this formula, where Q is the quantity of storm water which is measured in meter cube per second. Then C is coefficient of runoff, I intensity of rainfall which is taken in mm per hour, A drainage area which is measured in hectares. So by this formula we can say that for the application of rational method, the selection of coefficient C and rainfall intensity I are required, which can be obtained by the correct judgment. The area A can be more accurately determined by the three steps. In the first step, the plan of city is prepared and tentative arrangement of the sewer line is done. The whole area is divided into number of zones and the concentration points along the proposed sewer lines are marked on the plan of the city. In the second step, the selection of rainfall frequency and the rainfall intensity for this frequency is determined. The time of concentration of storm water, it includes inlet time and the time of travel. The inlet time is the time which is required for the rain in falling on the most remote center of the tributary area to flow across the ground surface along the drains up to the inlet of the sewer. The time of travel is the time which is required by the storm water in travelling from the uppermost inlet up to the point of concentration. And in the third step, the proportion of rainfall which enters the sewer directly as runoff is determined. The runoff coefficient or the value of runoff coefficient C is required in the rational method. The whole quantity of rain that falls over the ground does not reach the sewer lines or the drain. So the remaining portion of it percolates in the ground. Some portion gets evaporated and some portion is stored in the ponds or the ditches. And the remaining portion of rainwater reaches the drains and the sewers. The runoff coefficient is a fraction which is multiplied with the quantity of total rainfall to determine the quantity of rainwater which will reach the sewer. After continuous rainfall for some time, the ponds or ditches are filled up and the atmosphere becomes nearly saturated. Therefore, the runoff coefficient mainly depends upon the characteristics of the ground surface as porosity, wetness, ground cover, etc. Here are two tables are given, in which in table 4.1, runoff coefficient for various types of surfaces are given. So in one column types of surfaces are there and in the second column value of runoff coefficient with respect to that type of surface is given. And in the second table, table 4.2, runoff coefficient for the different types of localities are given. In the column type of locality, next to that column approximate average density of that population, and next to that runoff coefficient according to the different types of localities are given. So by knowing that value, as every locality consists of different types of the surface areas, so for calculating the overall runoff coefficient, the formula used is runoff coefficient C is equals to A1 into C1 plus A2 into C2 plus dot 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 plus AN into CN, which is divided by A1 plus A2 plus dot 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 plus AN, which will be equals to summation of A into C divided by summation of A. In this formula, A1, A2, A3 up to AN are the different types of area, and C1, C2, C3 up to CN are their runoff coefficients respectively. To understand this concept or to understand the estimation of stormwater, let us see the problem which says that the catchment area of a city is 200 hectares. Assuming that the surface on which the rain falls are classified as, here is one table is given in which type of surface, percentage area and its respective runoff coefficient is given. So for the roof, percentage area is 20% and runoff coefficient is 0.9. For pavement and yards, percentage area is 15, runoff coefficient is 0.8. For the lawns and garden, percentage area is 30 and runoff coefficient is 0.15. For macadamized roads, percentage area is 20 and runoff coefficient is 0.40. For vacant plots, percentage area is 15 and runoff coefficient is 0.10. By knowing this value, calculate the impervious factor. If the maximum intensity of rainfall is 40 mm per hour, then estimate the quantity of storm water which will reach the sewer line. So to calculate the quantity of storm water, first calculate the runoff coefficient C. So runoff coefficient C is calculated by the formula A1C1 plus A2C2 plus up to ANCN, which is divided by A1 plus A2 plus up to AN. So we have the catchment area of the city is 200 acres. So for that catchment area, multiply by 200. Then A1 is 20% of total area. So 20% of 200 acres. Then catchment area is 0.9. Plus A2 is pavement and yards, that is 15% area, and coefficient is 0.8. Plus A3 will be lawns and garden, whose area is 30% and coefficient is 0.15. A4 is macadamized roads, where percentage area is 20% and runoff coefficient is 0.40. And A5 is vacant plots, whose percentage area is 15 and runoff coefficient is 0.10, which is divided by 200 into A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus A4 plus A5. As in this table, total 5 types of surfaces are given. That's why area will be A1, A2, A3, A4 and A5. By solving this, we can get the coefficient of runoff, or runoff coefficient C is 0.44. So put this value of C in the rational method formula, which says that Q is equals to C into I into A upon 360. So here is we calculated runoff coefficient C, that is 0.44. into I is the intensity of rainfall, which is given as 40 mm per hour, so multiply by 40. Into A is the total catchment area, which is given as 200 hectares. So equation will be 0.44 into 40 into 200 upon 360, which will give the quantity of the storm water, which is equals to 9.778 meter cube per second.